Greetings, fellow citizens. Today we are testing the Terrapins, the Turtle, and in 3.6 you actually adjusted the angle of the engines. Look how it was in 3.5. In 3.5 the engines were at an angle of about 40 degrees, which is very bad. However, it's still not good. Yes, I know, it's a game, but I like good engineering and I love physics. And I feel a lot more immersed in a game if those things are done right. But no, they are not done right. The exhaust of the front engines would hit the rear engines, and even if the exhaust of the front engines would clear the rear engines, this is still not a very efficient design. The front engines are still at an angle of about, let's say, 10-15 degrees, which isn't very smart if you don't want to burn a lot of fuel for nothing. I really wish that one fine day at least one of the people who make the decisions at CIG would have a basic understanding of engineering and physics. We are starting with one Saiswan missile. Shields front side 86, stern at maximum. And one Saiswan missile. Shields front side 80, stern at maximum. The front of the ship was flashing, this means the front took damage, but I only look for orange or red spots on the HUD. It would take me way too much time to scan after every single missile and torpedo test. Sorry. One Saiswan missile on the way. Shields front side 77, stern at maximum. And the bigger missiles. One Saiswan missile. Shields front side 67, stern at maximum. Front was flashing, so front took damage, but it would take me too long to scan after every hit. Sorry. Two Saiswan missiles. Shields front side 35, stern at maximum, and still no visible damage and no cosmetic damage. Three Saiswan missiles. Shields front side 5, stern at maximum. We have orange spots and we are in a damaged state. Any cosmetic damage? Nope. Let's take a short look around. We have smoke and sparks. We have warning lights and more sparks and fire. Well, we had fire in previous patches, but I guess we have upgraded our fire extinguisher system. Yeah, no more fire. I think this looks fine. I mean, this surely gives you the impression I should leave. Quickly, very, very quickly. Let's see what we can still do. We still have our guns. We have normal SCM speed and afterburner. And this looks like normal flight controls with some very silly reflections. What's this? Oh, come on, Chris. Do we really need this? I don't need this. Well, looks like we are fine. Four, that's four missiles. And torpedoes, one Saiswan 5. Torpedo locking on and fire. Shields all around at 63. Another of those ships that are a little bit shorter, and one size 5 torpedo aimed at the front hits all four shield faces. CIG really has to rethink the shield face concept. It's very gamey in my opinion. Two size 5 torpedoes. Shields all around at 28. We are again in a damaged state and the center is orange. We have our guns. Oh, this is sluggish. Very sluggish. I have a hard time to pitch up. Why? We didn't lose anything, did we? This is very, very sluggish. Come on, pitch up, pitch up. Yeah, okay, this is not fun. And as always, just for fun, one size 9 torpedo. I don't want to repeat myself over and over, so have those two memes, and I use missiles and torpedoes just as a yardstick. And the terrapin is done in 3.6. Before I start discussing the results, in my test I use alpha damage only, so ships with a lot of shield HPs are looking good in my tests. However, depending on what you are fighting, you might be much better off with shields that have a higher regen rate, that have no regen delay damaged, or that are more stealthy. I tested this and link to my videos are in the top right corner. For now, in my tests where I use alpha damage, the Terrapin is much tougher than the Cutlass now and not as tough as the Andromeda. And again, we have this gamey feature that ships that are a little bit shorter can take missile and torpedo hits much better because all four shield faces are absorbing damage, while ships that are a little bit longer take a lot more damage because only front and side shields are absorbing damage when hit at the front by one size X missile or torpedo. Let's take a look at the comparison. I have data of the Terrapin from 3.1 to today, and between 3.5 and 3.6 she has now 1.5 times as many shield HPs, but missile and torpedo damage was buffed a lot too. Size 1 missile 95, now 86. Size 2 missile 92 and now 80. Size 3 missile 86 and now 77. In 3.5 she was destroyed by 5 size 4 missiles, now she is destroyed by 4 size 4 missiles. In 3.5 2 size 5 torpedoes, shields at 47% and now shields are at 28%. In 3.5 she could survive one size 9 torpedo, was destroyed by 2, and now she is destroyed by 1 size 9 torpedo. Would I go into battle in the Terrapin? Well, this is one of the few ships where I cannot answer this question, because the Terrapin has a very special role. She is out and is looking for target and scanning, and we don't really have this looking for targets and reporting positions of targets back to the main body yet in game, so I cannot really answer the question if I would go into battle in a Terrapin, and I also cannot give any rating right now. As always, the link to my data sheet and to Maloko's wonderful data is in the description below. I hope you had fun watching this video and see you next time. Bye, auf Wiedersehen. Hey, this guy is very interested in his new shield generator. Find anything interesting? Is it the good stuff? I decided to put this at the end of my toughness test videos from now on. If you already know this, then just skip it. So how tough is your ship? There are different factors, and I start with the hard factors. How many shield hit points does the shield generator provide? What armor does the ship have? Right now all ships only have some generic armor values. And how many hit points do different parts of your ship have? Then we have soft factors. How big is your ship? How many shield faces are hit by an attack? And how easily are certain parts of your ship getting destroyed? For instance, some ships are prone to losing wing guns or wings. And then we have bugs. Right now we have a bug that the shields don't cover the whole shape of the ship, especially when the shape is elongated.